The Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Stephen Kazimba, was impressed by the progress so far in the development of oil and gas in Bunyoro. Together with members of the House of Bishops, he visited the Kingfisher Oilfield in Buhuka and Kabalega International Airport in Hoima District.
We should rejoice for what we are seeing. Mm. You know, it is easier to grumble than to appreciate. Mm. Grumbling is so near to us than appreciating. So this is something that should bring a smile on each one of us, instead of lamenting. Mm.
The Archbishop asked the government to inject more money into the projects being implemented and has further requested that the government considers employing more Ugandans in these projects.
To appreciate, but also to call upon the government, these projects we have seen, they need more resources. And we should find ways of injecting in more resources. And our people here to get jobs. I have been impressed to see that there are many Ugandans employed here. And that's very important. I think if you can work on this even more, that we can have 98% of Ugandans employed in our project, that is something that we really thank God.
The team of bishops held a special prayer dedicating the airport and other works taking place in oil and gas to God.
Father, bless this airport. We bless and speak blessing for us.
Yes.
Bless the engineers.
Amen.
Bless all those who are working here.
Amen.
We pray that even the remaining work, the resources will be provided.
Ernest Rubondo, the Executive Director of Petroleum Authority of Uganda, says the government has come up with a number of frameworks, such as the National Oil and Gas Policy, and they need to be implemented.
Uganda is privileged because by the time the oil and gas sector came, a lot of these processes were established, environmental law was in place. Therefore, the environmental aspects of the oil and gas sector or oil and gas work is very well documented, is very well detailed. Aspects of noise, aspects of waste are very well detailed.
Rubondo revealed that Uganda has put in place the framework to curb corruption in Uganda and has requested religious leaders to help in fighting the vice.
Now, you will agree that addressing corruption comes from two fronts, and it's very nice that we are discussing this with the House of Bishops. Because the first one is on the individual, as a human being, as a person. What is your thinking about corruptors? As you appreciate, there are people who will never be corrupt. There are people who might say, well, under some circumstances, maybe. There are others who are looking out for the opportunity to benefit from corruption. And we all belong in those venues. That's the first level of the individual.
Zakaria Lubega, an official from Sinuk Uganda Limited, explains that the company has managed to follow the international guidelines of mitigating noise pollution in the area of operation while carrying out the drilling processes.
Moderation that we've done ensure that if we are generating noise from the drilling area to the nearest receptor or the nearest settlement, looking at the permissible noise levels within the country and following the international guidelines, how is the noise going to be, how is the pollution going to be to the nearest receptor? And the land acquisition put in consideration for that, including the modifications in the equipment that is being used, including the drilling rig. We're at the rig, but you can hardly notice that the rig is under operation.
Amos Murisa says the airport was strategically built in the middle of all the oil and gas projects for easy and equal access.
So the whole of this section, the upper part is the refinery, the lower part is the pump station one and part of the fertilizer complex.
Uganda is expected to have her first oil by June 2025. Report by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.